Back-to-back testing is used to ensure equivalence between models and their associated code. Back-to-back testing is a recommended practice in standards such as ISO 26262 and DO 254. In this video, we'll look at an example to create and run back-to-back testing on a Simulink model. This model is for a cruise control system that we've already generated code for. Let's use the Create Test for Component wizard in Simulink Test to set up a suite of back-to-back tests to verify equivalence between the Simulink model and its associated automatically generated code. When performing back-to-back testing, a best practice is to use test inputs, which exercise as much of your models as possible. We can use Simulink Design Verifier to generate test inputs for maximum model coverage, which is measured by Simulink coverage. When performing back-to-back testing, you execute the same tests on the model and generated code. The outputs from the model and the code should be numerically equivalent. We can use Simulink Design Verifier's enhanced MCDC feature to generate test inputs for which the effects will be more observable at the model output. We can select input source and file format here, and we can generate the tests. I will fast forward through the test generation. And after the tests are generated, we get a single test suite to run the model through. I'll fast forward through running these tests, and we can view the results. We see that we passed all of the equivalence tests and can view the results of each individual test. In this video, I showed you how to use Simulink Test, Simulink Coverage, and Simulink Design Verifier to perform back-to-back testing to verify numerical equivalence between a Simulink model and its associated automatically generated code. Ensuring maximum model coverage is a best practice, but you can do more to ensure equivalence. We will have follow-on videos to describe these practices.